Okay, magandang gabi mga kapatid. Nandito tayo ngayon sa ating weekly catechism. Ang title ng ating lecture ngayon is about how to make a good confession using the Ten Commandments as a guide. Ngayon, nandito tayo sa Lent, Kwaresma. This is the season for reflection. I hope, no, ginagamit natin this time sa pagninilay-nilay in solidarity with all our brothers and sisters in the whole world to reflect our sins and to reflect on the suffering of Christ sa atin, no? Alang-alang sa ating mga kasalanan, tinubos niya tayo sa hindi naman niya kasalanan. Malapit na tayo sa Holy Week, and then usually kagawian na ko-confess tayo. So as a guide, magandang guide ang Ten Commandments one by one, and then yung Seven Deadly Sins one by one gamitin natin as a guide. Magkuha tayo ng papel, ballpen, lilista natin para hindi natin makalimutan. And before doing that, we pray to the Holy Spirit to guide us. So, medyo rundown, mabilis tong lecture natin ngayong gabi dahil kada commandment, usually isang oras ang lecture. So, pagkakasyahin natin to sa isang lecture, 1 hour lecture, kaya kung i-download ko itong video, i-post yun na lang ang, kasi may PowerPoint naman, medyo mabilis to ngayon, no? So, ang natural law, yung commandments ni God, nakasulat sa ating puso. Lahat ng tao na pinanganak, automatic nakasulat sa ating puso yung kanyang batas, yung kanyang utos. Kaya, alam natin ang right from wrong. Ituro man sa isang tao, alam niyang meron siyang inkling, meron siyang nararamdaman niya na mali ang kumuha ng mga bagay na hindi sa iyo. Masama ang kunin mo yung asawa ng kapwa mo, no? Masama yung sasaktan mo ang magulang mo. Meron tayong tinatawag na natural law, no? Pero dahil sa original sin, yung ginawa ni Adam and Eve, yung ating first parents, nagka-develop tayo ng tinatawag na concupiscence. Because of our fallen nature, naging hindi na siya masyadong klaro ang natural law sa atin. Kaya God stepped in and then binigay niya sa atin yung Ten Commandments para wala na talaga tayong rason, no? Binigay niya sa atin para maging malinaw. Kung basahin niyo yung Bible, ang Ten Commandments nakasulat doon sa Exodus at saka sa Deuteronomy. Actually, yung Ten Commandments, hindi talaga nakasulat pag binasa mong Bible, hindi siya talaga nakasulat clearly 1 to 10, no? Walang ang pag nag-anong Bible, walang chapter-chapter, mga verse-verse. So, tayo na lang ang nag-arrange yan as a memory help. We group it together para mas madaling ma-remember. Kung mapansin nyo, ang Ten Commandments na arrangement ng Catholic ay iba sa Protestant. At saka, dahil magkaiba ang ating arrangement, inakusahan tayo ng mga Protestante na binago daw natin ang Ten Commandments. At ito ay kaya tayong mga Katoliko ay peke. Hindi tayo totoong simbahan dahil binago daw natin. Sa totoo lang, sila ang nagbago sa dating arrangement ng mga church fathers. Okay? Explain natin kung bakit ganito ang arrangement natin at saka ganito yung arrangement nila. At saka sinong yung mas plausible, mas maganda ang arrangement. Hindi naman makakasalanan kung i-follow mo yung sa kanila, pero mas may sense, no? Kasi ang nag-arrange nito ang mga church fathers, early Christians. Pagdating nila 1500s, 1500 years after, kanilang binago ang arrangement para mapanindigan yung kanilang mga turo at doktrina. So ito yung sa Protestante, no? Ito yung sa Katoliko. So para mas madali natin makita ang difference, side by side natin. Ang pansinin nyo, ang "you shall not covet your neighbor's wife" and "you shall not covet your neighbor's goods" sa Catholic ay 9 and 10 yan. Sa commandment number 9, wife; commandment number 10, goods. Pero sa Protestante, inisa nila. Commandment number 10 lang siya. "You shall not covet your neighbor's goods." Bakit? Kasi in-split nila ang commandment number 1, ginawa nilang 1 and 2. Pero originally, ang sense ng commandment number 1 ay idolatry, no? God condemns, God forbids idolatry. So you shall not have strange gods before me, at saka you shall not make yourself an idol, graven image, and worship them. So kung iyong i-analyze yung dalawang commandment na yan, ang essence niyan ay isa, idolatry. Wala ka dapat ibang Diyos maliban sa ating Panginoon. So isa lang yan. Kanila, hinati nila para mapagbigyan ng diin ang ating mga rebulto, para makondina nila ang ating mga rebulto. Pero kung tutuusin mo, isa lang ang essence ng commandment number 1 at 2 ng mga Protestante. It is about other gods, worshiping other gods other than God. Pero para mapagbigyan ng pansin at diin, para makundinan nila ang ating mga rebulto, para masabi nila, mapanindigan nila na tayo ay huwad at peke na simbahan, kaya nila in-split, no? Pero useless ang pag-split ng one commandment into two commandments, dahil one message lang sila. It's about idolatry and worshiping other gods. Ito namang commandment number 9 at saka 10, hindi pwedeng iisahin mo. Na you shall not, ito yung sa kanila, "you shall not covet your neighbor's goods." Bakit? Hindi mo sila pwedeng isahin dahil ang wife o yung husband ay hindi siya property, hindi siya goods. Iba yung wife at saka husband. Huwag kang, do not desire your neighbor's wife and husband. It's more on the lust of the thought. Yung neighbor's goods, iba siya. Dahil property siya, it's more on the greed and envy, no? Sa pag-iinggit ng mga property ng iba at saka kagahaman. Kaya hindi siya pwedeng isahin yung number 9 at saka number 10. Kaya mas may sense yung ating arrangement. Hindi po binago ng Katoliko ang commandment. More on, tayo ay nagfa-follow sa Deuteronomy na arrangement rather than sa Exodus. Ito. "You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself an image in the form of anything in heaven, above, or in earth. You shall not bow down to them or worship them." So kung babasahin mo yan, mga kapatid, yung sa Deuteronomy, isang sense lang siya. It's about idolatry. Kaya minabuti natin, minarapat natin na isang commandment lang yan. Mahaba ang commandment number 1. Okay? And then, yun, na-explain na natin yan. Okay. So, at saka, ito rin ang sinasabi ng iba. Hindi na tayo, yung Protestants claim, maraming Protestants, "we are not under the law, we are under grace." Kaya kayo mga Katoliko, masyado kayong mabusisi na commandment number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ang sa atin lang, ay we have to love, we have to believe in Jesus Christ in faith. Huwag na tayong masyadong conscious sa mga law. Dahil si Jesus fulfilled all the law, so the law does not no longer apply. Kaya kung mapansin mo, yung mga kapatid nating mga Protestante, yung mga Pentecostal, born again, iba, hindi masyado conscious about they want to follow the Bible, they want to follow the commandments, pero at a certain extent. Kasi pag sa morality wise na talaga, hindi sila ganon kabusisi dahil at the back of their mind, we are under grace. Hindi na tayo kailangan, hindi tayo maliligtas sa pag-fulfill ng law. Dahil ang law no longer apply. Because sabi sa Bible, we are under grace and not by law. Pero bunga yan, mga kapatid, ng maling interpretasyon. Ano bang law na pinagsasabi dito? Law ba ng commandments? Hindi. Hindi commandments yung inabolish ni God. Sabi ni Jesus, I came, no? Sa ating gospel reading ngayong araw, no? I did not come to abolish the law but to fulfill it. No, wala siyang inabolish. Actually, we have been freed, no? Pinalaya tayo ng Diyos ni Jesus sa 613 Jewish laws. Yun yung law na sinasabi ni St. Paul, we are not under law. It is about the law of Moses, hindi yung 10 commandments. Kasi morality yon. The 10 commandments is about morality. We have been free, pinalaya tayo from the ceremonial laws. No? From the ceremonial laws. Hindi tayo pinalaya sa mga morality. No? The law of morality. The 10 commandments is about the law of morality. No? It is about the 613 Jewish law. Kaya hindi na tayo nag-observe ng kosher, ceremonial, dietary laws, feast days, mga ganon. Hindi na. Because we are not Jews. It is only for the Jews. It is binding for the Jews and the Old Covenant. So, Jesus fulfilled already in Himself. Long ceremonial washing laws. Hindi na tayo naghuhugas ng kamay. Naghuhugas tayo for hygiene purposes, pero hindi na yung magkakasala tayo pag hindi tayo naghuhugas, no? Ceremonial washing laws, kosher laws, circumcision laws, dietary laws, no? Kaya pwede tayong kumain ng mga ano, kahit ano. Yung dati, kahit mga isda na walang kaliskis, kasalanan pag kumain ka ng isda na walang kaliskis. Kaya pwede tayong kumain ng pusit, pwede tayong kumain ng shrimp, yon. The feast laws. So Moses wrote 613 Jewish laws. God wrote the 10 commandments himself. Siya mismo nagsulat ng with his fingers the 10 commandments, no? Ang nagsulat ng 613 Jewish laws ay si Moses. So okay, let's go to the 10 commandments. The first 3 commandments is about loving God, no? You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not take the name of the Lord in Lord's name in vain. You shall keep the Lord's day holy. So it's about God. And the rest is about loving our neighbor. So the other term of 10 commandments is Decalogue. Deca means 10. So sa New Testament, itong 10 commandments, pwede mo masummarize into 2 commandments. Pero hindi ibig sabihin sa 10 commandments, kasi may ibang mga preacher na ririnig ko, sabi niya, hindi na 10 ngayon, 2 na lang. No, hindi tinanggal ang 10. Sinummarize lang. Pero the 10 commandments will always apply because it is a morality, no? Law of morality. So, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. So that is the greatest commandment. So That is the first commandment. Yan ang pinaka-importante. And then, the second is, love your neighbor as yourself. And all the law, meaning all these commandments, is summarized to this. Okay. All the commandments are linked to each other. Don't forget this. This is very important, mga kapatid. Lahat ng mga commandments, itong sampo, ay connected to one another. Kahit may isa ka na lang, may isang commandments ka sa sampo na i-break, lahat, bin-break mo lahat. No? So, nilabag mo lahat pag may isa. Kasi akala ng iba, pumipili lang. Oh, mabait ako, nagbibigay ako sa mahirap. Oh, hindi ako pumapatay. Pero, may kalaguyo naman. Namatay na may kalaguyo. So, akala nila safe na sila kasi hindi sila pumapatay. Pero, nag-adultery. No? Meron silang pornography. Ganito, sabi sa Bible, James chapter 2, verse 11. Whoever keeps the whole law, yet stumbles in just one, is guilty of breaking all of it. Kaya nga sabi sa catechism natin, one mortal sin, unrepented mortal sin, is enough to send you to hell. Kahit isa lang. So, hindi kailangan you break all the Ten Commandments. So, kahit bait ka sa lahat, pero you are guilty of stealing, one mortal sin is enough to send you to hell. Unrepented mortal sin. For example, sabi dito ni St. James, you shall not commit adultery. You shall not murder. If you do not commit adultery but you commit murder, you have become a lawbreaker. Kaya, yung sampo na yan, connected lahat yan. Break one and you break all. Okay. If we do not love our neighbor, we do not love God. Ito rin. So, kahit napaka-importante na commandment number one, we have to love God. Pero pag you don't love your neighbor, interconnected yung dalawa, you do not love God also. Yung iba, may mga theologians na nagtuturo. Watch out. Kasi daw, kahit atheist ka, kahit hindi ka naniniwala sa Diyos, wala kang pakialam sa Diyos, wala kang pakialam sa kahit anong religion, but you are a good person, you help the poor, you can be saved. Huwag kayo maniwala doon because they are making the second commandment more important. Anong sabi sa Bible? The greatest commandment of all is the first. You have to love God with all your heart. So, kahit you love your neighbor, but you don't have anything to do with God without reference to God, you are not loving God. No? Ang sinasabi lang dito, importante, hindi mo masasabing you love God if you don't love your neighbor. But even if you love your neighbor but you don't love God, you also do not love your neighbor. It is a fake love of neighbor because it is interconnected, the two of that. You have to love God first. And then you can love your neighbor if you love God. You love your neighbor because of the love of God. Okay. So, pwede pa rin masummarize ang Ten Commandments into 10 words. Let God be God and do the will of God. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, that is 10 words. Let God be God and do the will of God. Okay. So, ang commandments, mga kapatid, the Ten Commandments have two principles. It can be summarized by two. Ano to? So, ang Ten Commandments, mga kapatid, ay hindi lang siya pagbabawal. Thou shalt not, thou shalt not, thou shalt not. Hindi lang siya pagbabawal. Kundi, may gagawin ka rin. So, ang commandments, in summary, have two principles. Do good and avoid evil. May pinagbabawal at may pinapagawa. Offense, kagaya sa basketball, offense and defense. Di pwedeng puro defense lang. May gagawin ka, may responsibilidad ka. Hindi ka rin pwedeng offense lang. May defense ka. Lahat yan para manalo ka. Okay, let's go to the first commandment. You must not have any other God but me. So, alam natin yan. First commandment is about God. Wala ka ng ibang Diyos. Hindi ka pwedeng mag-idolatry. So, first, ang pinapagawa sa atin sa commandment number one, ang ating responsibility, we must have faith, hope, and love of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 13. Hindi lang yung pwedeng hindi pwede lang na wala kang idolatry. Hindi, may gagawin ka. You have to have faith. May pananampalataya ka na healthy. You have to study, no? You have to have a strong faith. Kailangan ng strong faith. So paano ka magkakaroon ng strong faith? You have to study. You have to make an act of faith always. You have to pray. You have to hope and love. The greatest of this is love. So you have to pray always. Responsibility natin sa commandment number one is to pray always. Unite with God in prayer. And then you have to respect holy things like the sacraments, no? Saints, mga priests, mga holy things. We have to respect it. It forbids idolatry, no? So worshiping other God, other religion, no? And hindi lang yan, wala naman ngayon, hindi na uso ngayon yung nagtutuwad-tuwad ka, luluhod-luhod ka sa harap ng golden calf. Pero pwede, meron na yun. Ang pinakauso ngayon na idolatry is ang the God of self. Yung sarili natin, nagiging Diyos. Paano yun? Magiging Diyos yung sarili natin pag if yung mga social advancement, worldly pleasure, bodily comfort, nauuna pa sa ating pag-serve kay God. Pag ito ay mas nauna pa yung ating mga hobby, yung friends natin, yung pera, yung ating mga pleasure, mga happiness, nauna pa kay God, it becomes idolatry, self-God. At saka yung superstition, at saka involving in occult, yan. We are putting our trust in the anting-anting. We are putting in trust in feng shui, in pampaswerte. Now that's already also we are guilty of tarot cards. We go to mga manghuhula, albularyo, no, spirit of the glass, occult things. It is against the first commandment. Nagpapadugo, no? We are trusting in the encanto, mga spirit para to appease, no, para pahupain yung galit ng mga encanto, ganun. And then, alam nyo ba, pinagbabawal ang pag-attend ng service ng ibang sekta. No, hindi tayo pwede magsimba sa kanila. Pwede ka siguro mag-attend, you can pray with them, you can praise and worship with them, but not on the Lord's Day. You cannot attend false worship service because that is not the worship that God wants. Hindi po yan ang worship na gusto ng Diyos. Gusto niya yung Eucharist, the sacrifice of the Mass, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Meron dapat priest, merong pare. Hindi pwede yung banda, walang altar. That is a false worship. And then, under the first commandment, no? Being a member of the Freemason is a grave sin. Maraming hindi nakakaalam nito. Sin against the first commandment. Sabi sa canon law, 1983 Congregation of Doctrine of Faith, no? States the faithful who enroll in Masonic associations are in state of grave sin and may not receive Holy Communion, and membership in Masonic association is prohibited. Okay, if you want to ask why, another topic yan, mahaba yan. Okay, tempting God against the first commandment. Sabihin mo, pag ginawa mo to Lord, gagawin ko to. Pag hindi mo to ginawa, hindi ko to gagawin. That is tempting God. Matthew 4:7 sabi, it is written, you shall not tempt the Lord your God. You are making yourself God. Pag sinabi mo, pag ginawa mo to, gagawin ko to. Nakikipag-deal-deal ka pa kay God, no? So, tinetempt mo si God. Sabi ni God, let God be God and do the will of God. No? And then, pag gumawa ka ng kasalanan, para kang nagsiserve ng ibang God. Kasi kada kasalanan, meron siyang demon behind it. Mga lesser gods, those are demons. Like for example, pride. The god of the pride is Lucifer. The god of greed is Mammon. The god of lust is Asmodeus. Mga demons to. The god of envy is Leviathan. The god of gluttony is Beelzebub. The god of wrath is Satan. The god of slot is Belphegor. No? So, itong mundo natin mga kapatid, the world has three gods: sex, money, and power. Kaya para matalo itong three gods of this world, the sex, money, and power, kaya mga religious at saka mga clergy pumapasok sa vow of chastity, poverty, and obedience, because the vow of chastity defeats the god of sex. The vow of poverty defeats the god of money. The vow of obedience defeats the god of power. Kaya yan ang tatlo ang tatalo sa kanila, etong chastity, poverty, and obedience. And then also, kaya tayo sa Lent, yung prayer, penance, and almsgiving. No? Fasting, almsgiving, and prayer. Okay. Exodus, do not make yourself an image in the form of anything. So, mga kapatid, let us go. Yan. Hindi tayo pwedeng maggawa ng graven images. Hindi lang yung graven images na pinagbabawal, kundi pinagbabawalan tayo ni God gumawa ng graven images para gawin nating Diyos. Yun po, hindi yung graven images bawal. Kasi kung absoluto ang Diyos, absolute si God na pinagbabawal lahat ng graven images, then God will contradict himself. No? Ang pinagbabawal ni God, gagawa tayo ng graven images para gawin nating Diyos at saka paglingkuran natin at we worship them. Yung pagluhod, mga kapatid, hindi po yan worship. No? It is a sign of respect. So, gagawa tayo ng ribulto at iisipin natin na yung espiritu ng Diyos ay andyan sa kanya, at paglilingkuran natin yung ribulto na yan at gagawin nating Diyos natin, yan ang pinagbabawal. Pero yung graven images per se is not. Bakit? Kasi si God mismo nagutos kay Moses gumawa ng cherubim. Cherubim is an angel. Ilagay doon sa Ark of the Covenant. And then si God mismo nagutos kay gumawa ng graven image ng serpent. Kung sino man ang titingin sa serpent na yon ay gagaling. Gagaling mula sa venom ng mga serpents na kumagat sa kanila. No? So, si God mismo ay nagko-contradict kung absolute ang kanyang commandment na bawal ang graven image. Meron pong dugtong. Hindi lang doon tumigil sa do not make graven image. Ang dugtong niya, do not worship them. Yun. Pag winorship mo na, kung you consider them as God, yun na ang kasalanan. We do not worship the plastic, the stone, the wood of the ribulto. We worship what it represent. Ang nire-represent ng ribulto, si Jesus. But we worship Jesus and that statue in spirit and in truth. Hindi tayo tumatagos yung ating worship sa langit. Alam natin ang ating God ay nasa langit. Hindi dun nakapansin. We are, it represents, no? Ang winoworship natin kung sino yung nire-representa niya. Hindi mismo yung bato. Kasi yung mga tao dati sa Old Testament, yung bato mismo, akala nila andun talaga yung Diyos nila, nakatira doon. Pumapasok yung espiritu ng kanilang Diyos. Okay? So, we venerate or worship the image it represents. Hindi mismo yung image. Okay. So, as a summary, yung questionnaire na tatanungin natin sa first commandment ay, do I give God time in every day in prayer? No? So, wag tayong tumagal dito kasi wala tayong time. I-pause nyo lang to at saka you ask these questions. Are there things more important in my life than God? Have I been involved in superstitious practices or the occult? Do I seek to do God's will or my will in my life? Have I ever received Holy Communion in the state of grave sin? No? Yun, part pa ng first commandment, sacrilege. Ko-communion ka, may mortal sin ka, hindi ka nag-confess. Now, let's go to the second commandment. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. Huwag mong ordinaryuhin ang pangalan ni Lord. Ang mga Jews, very holy sa kanila ang word ni God, no? Na hindi nila to sinasabi. Ang nagsasabi lang nito ang mga high priest. Ito yung Yahweh, YHWH, galing ito sa word na I am who am, yod he, wow he, tetragrammaton, four letter word, nilagyan na lang ng vowel para ma-pronounce Yahweh, no? So, hindi nila to basta-basta sinasabi because this is holy, no? We must have reverence in speaking about God and holy things. Reverence, great respect. Yung mga holy things like the saints, mga sacraments, no? The Mother of God. Keeping our oaths, pati yung oath natin, because pag sinabing oath, sinasali natin ang name ni God. Kaya huwag tayong magsabi ng oath ng padalos-dalos at saka hindi naman masyadong importante. We are profaning the name of God if we don't keep our vows. Yung vow natin sa marriage at saka sa religious, pag hindi natin tinupad, iniwan natin asawa natin, doble ang kasalanan natin. Commandment number 2 at saka commandment number 6, you shall not commit adultery, no? Blasphemy. Ang blasphemy ay we speak about God, about the saints, about holy things with ridicule, pangungutya at ginagawa nating katawa-tawa or contempt, merong galit o may malisya, no? For example, sa pagsinabi mo, if God is, kung mabuti ang Diyos, bakit niya hinayaan itong mangyari sa akin? That is already blasphemy. If God is good. So kung mahal ako ng Diyos, bakit niya ako hinayaan mag, ano ito? Be careful of that, no? If that guy wants, kung ang taong yan ay mapupunta sa langit, dahil siguro hindi niya gusto yung taong yan. Pag napunta siya sa langit, mas gugustuhin ko pang mapunta sa impyerno. Yan. That is example of blasphemy, no? For example, ang Bible, puno yan ng fairy tale lang yan, no? Hocus pocus. Ang banal na misa, ang mass, wala yan. Hocus pocus lang yan, fable, myth. Di totoo yan, that is blasphemy. And then also irreverence use of God's name. Depende, it could be mortal sin pag masyadong mabigat, venial sin pag hindi mo sinadya or hindi mo napag-isipan. For example, kahit yung mag-type ko lang ng OMG, no? Yung oh my God, huwag mong ano yan. That the name of God is holy. Huwag mong gawing expression. Pwede ka siguro magsabi, oh my gulay, okay lang. Oh my gosh. Pag huwag yung oh my God, huwag mong... Pag nahulog ka, natapilo ka at sabi, oh my God, pwede yon. Kasi you are naghihingi ka ng tulong kay God, no? Pero yung mga... Gawin mo lang siyang expression... Yung iba nagagalit, sabi nila Jesus Christ, yung nagagalit sa tapos ginagamit nila si Jesus na expression. Nako, that is, it could be a mortal sin, no? Ano, sabi ng iba, for Christ's sake, stop that making noise. No, yan, blasphemy yan. Huwag nating ordinaryuhin yung Sus Mario Josep. Saan ba galing yung Sus Mario Josep? Pag hindi mo alam yung meaning at saka hindi mo sinasadya, pwedeng venial sin. Galing yan sa Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. Sus Maria Josep. Huwag mong ordinaryuhin. Yung, uy, Jesus ko. Yun. Huwag mong ordinaryuhin niya yung mga kwento-kwento ka lang. Ginagamit mo yan, no? Tapos yung iba, pa-insulto pa. O, saan na yung kumari mo? Ayun. Sa, kumusta na yung business ng kapitbahay mong inggitera? Sa awa ng Diyos, ayun, nalugi na. Gamitin mo pa yung pangalan ng Diyos, sa awa ng Diyos, nalugi. That is blasphemy. No? Irreverence use of name. Profanity. So, it could be mortal sin pag ito ay sanhi ng grave scandal. Pag ikaw ay parent, tapos nakatingin sa iyo yung anak mo, tapos nawalan sila ng respeto sa pangalan ng Diyos, gumagaya sila sa iyo, tawag dyan grave scandal, meaning sin of bad example, scandal. Dahil sa iyo, naging sanhi ng anak mo na hindi nagrespeto sa pangalan ng Diyos, it could be a mortal sin. Be careful. False oaths. yung false oath, yung sabihin mo, no, I'm telling you the truth. Totoo yan. Hindi ako nagnakaw ng candy. Candy-candy lang magsasagamitin mo pangalan ni God. No, I swear to God, totoo yan. Hindi yan. Pwede mo lang gamitin pag sa mga korte at sa mga importante-importante na talaga. Because, sabi, ito yung principle, mga kapatid. First of all, there must be a good reason for taking an oath. God is not to be invoked lightly as our witness. Sa mga ordinaryong bagay, hindi mo gagamitin ng ano. Ang sabi sa Matthew chapter 5, verse 34, do not swear an oath at all, either by heaven, for it is God's throne, or by the earth, for it is his footstool, or by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great king. Nor should you swear by your head. Kahit maputol ang ulo ko, cross my heart, hope to die, kasalanan yan. Kasi you cannot make a single hair white or black, simply let your yes be yes and no, no. Anything more comes from the evil one. Okay. Huwag mong insultuhin ang mga pare na you saying mga insulting language or treatment, no? Especially in front of many people. Kahit ano, because sabi ni Jesus kay Saint Faustina, I will deal with my priests. So be careful. That is under the commandment number 2. So, in summary, the second commandment, you ask yourself, have I condemned someone in God's name? Sabi ka, God damn you. Ibig sabihin, sana may impyerno ka. Ikundina ka ng Diyos. Kasalanan yan. Do I say His name when I am angry? Have I used God's name lightly or carelessly? Have I insulted a sacred person, priest, or abused a sacred object, Eucharist? Have I broken a vow made in God's name? No? Kaya don't take lightly. If you promise God something, you do it. Huwag ka magsabi, Lord, MWF, magbe-bread and water lang ako. Tapos, without very grave reason, hindi mo tutuparin? No. Tuparin mo pag nag-make ka ng vow. Now, let's go to the third commandment. Remember to keep holy the day, the Sabbath day. In the Catholic Catechism, remember to keep the Lord's Day. Bakit hindi na tayo obligado to observe the Sabbath day? Because in keeping the Lord's Day, ating nagampanan ang Sabbath day sa pag-keep ng Lord's Day holy. Explain natin yan mamaya, no? So sa ating obligasyon sa third commandment, kailangan tayong mag-attend ng misa kada linggo, no? Yung iba nagsisimba sila ng anticipated mass on Saturday, tawag diyan vigil mass. No, kung pwede lang Sunday talaga. Kasi kung wala ka naman lang trabaho sa Sunday, dapat Sunday ka talaga mag-misa, hindi yung para madali lang para makapag-iskerda na kami sa ginagawa niyong linggo ang Saturday. No, it is designed for those people who must work on Sunday, like nurses and doctors, if ever attend mass on Sunday. Bakit Sunday? Bakit Jesus rose on Sunday. It is the day of resurrection. So you have to keep all Sunday as holy day of obligation. And then, napansin nyo, lahat sa New Testament, minention ni Jesus nung tinanong siya, anong gagawin ko para mapunta ng langit? Inenumerate niya ang 9 commandments, isa lang hindi niya sinabi, yung Sabbath day. Because Jesus fulfilled the Sabbath day in the Lord's day, in which the day He rose from the dead. So, Sabbath is made for man and not man for Sabbath. Sinong man yan? Si Jesus. No? Jesus is the Lord of the Sabbath. He is greater than the Sabbath. Kaya, we are already making holy the Lord's Day, the day He rose from the dead. At saka yung, holiday of obligation, kailangan nating magsimba. We have to treat it, dapat nating tratuhin to as a holiday of obligation. Ito, 3. Immaculate Conception, December 8. Christmas Day, December 25, Solemnity of Mother, January 1. Kailangan tayo magsimba kahit hindi ito Linggo. So anong gagawin natin? Dapat we have to rest on Sunday, rest from work as much as possible, and then every Christian should avoid making unnecessary demands on others. Maraming hindi nakakaalam nito, kahit mag-grocery, we have to avoid it. Kung pwede, gawin natin to ng Saturday, ang grocery shopping, kasi napipilitan yung iba sa pagtrabaho sa Sunday dahil doon natin ginagawa. Ito, Catechism 2187, like sports, restaurants, public services. Kasi yung iba hindi na sila nakakapagsimba dahil pinatrabaho sila ng Sunday dahil doon. Kami ngayon, nung nalaman namin itong lecture ni Father Isaac Relia, hindi na kami nagpupunta ng Pure Gold at saka mag-grocery ng Sunday. Ibang araw na. We have to, hindi lang mong rest, pray, read the Bible, do the charity work. Kung pwede, kaya kami Sunday after Mass, nanonood kami ng spiritual learning sa mga bata. Nanonood kami ng lecture sa YouTube about Father Chad Ripperger, Father Isaac. Nanonood kami with the kids and then Life of the Saint. May prayer talaga at saka may gospel inspiration. You treat Sunday as a day of learning about God. Okay. As Catholics, sabi ni Father Chris Aylar, most of my lecture is from Father Chris Aylar again. As Catholics, we try not to shop on Sundays because it forces people to work on Sundays. Example, Chick-fil-A sa Amerika, ang may-ari nito, napakasikat na chicken restaurant chain sa Amerika, ang may-ari ay Catholic. Every Sunday, close sila. Every Sunday, close ang Chick-fil-A. Very sikat. Dahil very devout Catholic ang may-ari ng Chick-fil-A. At saka, dapat tayo pumunta ng church. Dahil hindi pwedeng doon ka lang sa bahay mo magsimba, doon ka lang sa kota magsindi ng kandila. Dahil sabi dito, in the church, exclamations are cried out to God as one great heart. The union of minds, the accord of souls, the bond of charity, the prayers of the priests. You cannot get those alone, sabi ni St. John Chrysostom. So sa third commandment, ito yung summary. Do I reflect on the meaning of the resurrection every Sunday? Ito yung guide mo sa confession. Have I deliberately missed Mass on Sunday or holidays of obligation? It's a mortal sin pag wala kang mabigat na reason, hindi ka nagsimba. Okay? If you miss Mass na walang mabigat na reason, pag simba mo next Sunday, huwag ka munang mag-Eucharist, mag-communion kung hindi ka pa nakapag-confess, no? Have I tried to observe Sunday as a family day and a day of rest which includes prayer? So take note, which includes prayer. Baka nag-rest ka lang, hindi ka naman nag-pray. Do I do needless work or activities on Sunday like shopping that force others to work? Okay, now let's go to the fourth commandment. Honor your father and mother. So, it's about authority. It's not just about respecting your father and mother. It's about authority. Kabilang dito yung pag-obey your government, to obey your teacher. Lahat ng authority you have to obey. At saka hindi lang yung obey your parents, ang duty rin ito ng parents sa kanilang anak. Take care of your parents. Palakihin mo ng maayos. Paaralin mo, pakainin mo, turuan mo about God. Yung responsibility ng parents sa kanilang anak. Hindi lang yung anak, no. So kahit ano pang pinagdaanan mo sa parents mo, pag nangangailangan sila sa iyo, pag matanda na sila, you have to take care of them. No? Kahit hindi sila na naging mabuting magulang, may utang natin sa kanila because sila ang nagluwal sa atin dito sa mundo. So sa mga parents, we have the duty to take to teach our child about God. Maliit pa lang. So very sad yung iba. O nga, yung anak nila, college, cum laude, successful sa kanilang trabaho, may mga business. Pero atheist naman. Kasi wala silang time sa pagturo ng kanilang anak about prayer. Maliit pa, huli na ang lahat. No? Hinahiyaan nila magbasa ng kahit anong mga libro. Mga Harry Potter, mga nobela ng mga socialism, mga ano dyan. No? At saka, mortal sin, pag tayo ay sinaktan natin ang ating mga magulang kahit sa cursing them, insulting them, ridiculing them, no? We have to obey civil laws. Pero hindi tayo pwedeng mag-follow ng law ng government pag ito ay unjust. For example, if there will come a time na tayo ay pipilitin na mag ano sa mga artificial contraception or abortion or same-sex marriage, we are not allowed to follow unjust laws that goes against the law of God. No? So, anong responsibility natin sa ating bayan? We have to vote. Hindi tayo pwedeng mag-boycott. No? We have to defend our country if ever. So, the fourth commandment, summary. Take note, mga kapatid, hindi ito kumpleto lahat kasi summary lang ito. No? So, kung may na-miss out ako, kasi hindi ito detalyado. This is just the rundown of the Ten Commandments. So, summary of the fourth commandment, you have to ask yourself in the confession, do I try to bring peace into my home? Have I criticized politicians without praying for them? Dapat i-pray natin ating politicians, hindi lang tayo mag-criticize. Guilty of that minsan. Have I broken the law thinking it's no big deal? Mga speed limit. Nagbayad ba tayo ng taxes? Nag-cheat ba tayo sa ating tax? That is part of the fourth commandment, no? Yun. So on and so forth. Let's go to the fifth commandment. And then, sinasabi din pala nila, no, ng mga Protestant brothers and sisters natin, call no man your father. Bawal tayong magsabi. Yung mga pare, bawal natin sabihin ng father. Tama ba? No. Mali po yan. Mali na pag-interpret ng Bible. Sabi sa Luke 16:24, then he cried and said, Father Abraham. Oh, nasa Bible, Father Abraham. Call no man father in earth. Oh, sinabi sa Bible, Father Abraham. 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 15, sabi, I became your father through the gospel, sabi ni St. Paul. Sabi sa John 8:56, your father Abraham, Jesus said. So hindi bawal magsabi ng father sa ating mga magulang, sabi sa commandment number 4, honor your father and mother. O, nag-conflict na sana si God. No? Ang sinasabi lang dyan, ang ibig sabihin ni Jesus, call no man your father, is that there's only one creator, there's only one Abba, God the Father. Yun. At saka, we are no longer under the covenant of the patriarchs. Yun, Father Abraham, Isaac of Jacob. So, tayo ay hindi na tayo obligado sa covenant of the patriarch. Yun ang ibig sabihin. Okay? The fifth commandment, that you shall not kill. It's about the sanctity of life. Commandment na ito. So, pinagbabawal, kinukondena ang murder, abortion, suicide, euthanasia, mutilation. Anong mutilation? Yung ligation, no? Yung pagpapakapon, yung sterilization, oh, yun, pinagbabawal yan. Pinagbabawal din ang pananakit. Hindi mo pinapatay, sinasaktan mo asawa mo, sinusuntok mo yung mga tao, kalaban mo sa traffic, nagsusuntukan kayo. That is under commandment number 5, that is mortal sin. Yung justified, yung kasalanan ba yung pag yung nangyari sa pagdedepensa ng isang country, just war, no, justified yon. You have the obligation to defend yourself. Yung mga sundalo, police, pag nakapatay sila under kanilang duty, hindi po yung kasalanan kasi may responsibility sila to protect the citizens. Self-defense, justified din. Pero pag kahit lumpo na yung magnanakaw o hold upper, pinatay mo pa rin. That is, hindi na self-defense yan. Murder na yan. At saka, kinokondina rin ang unjust anger, hatred, vengeance under the commandment number 5, thou shall not kill. Under ito, bitterness, no? Nagtatanim ka ng galit, puot. Killing the reputation of others. Pinatay mo ang kanilang dangal kasi nag-iimbento ka ng mga kwento. So, hatred, no? Sabi ni Jesus, hindi ka mapapatawad kung hindi ka nagpatawad. Matthew chapter 5 verse 21, ang sabi, you have heard, do not murder. Anyone who murders will be subject to judgment. But I tell you, anyone who is angry with his brother will be subject to judgment. Para ka na rin nag-murder, no? Under commandment number 5, if you are angry with your brother. Anyone who says, you fool, will be subject to fire hell. No? Sira ulo ka. PI ka. O mga ganon. No? Will be subject to the fire of hell. Ang sabi ni Jesus, mas stricto nga si Jesus. Hindi niya inabolish ang law. Mas stricto pa siya. Ang commandment na niya ngayon, dati, no? Tooth for a tooth, eye for an eye. Ngayon, mas stricto si Jesus. Love your enemy. Yung enemy, you have to love and pray for those who persecute you. At saka kasalanan din ang mga paglalasing-lasing kasi hindi ka na nakakaisip, hindi mo na naisip yung sinasabi mo na pipinsala na yung katawan mo. Under commandment number 5, pag nag-drive ka, nalasing ka, mortal sin kasi makaka-aksidente ka kagaya ng nangyari doon, may napatay dahil lasing, nagda-drive, no? Commandment number 5. So, pag lasing ka, nag-drive ka, malaking kasalanan. So, the fifth commandment, summary niya, yung mga question na tatanungin mo, nag-encourage ba ako ng abortion? Nag-encourage ba ako ng ligation, artificial contraception? No? Have I used alcohol or drugs which can indirectly lead to destruction of the body? Did I give scandal to anyone leading him to sin? Nag-encourage ba ako? Sinabi ko ba sa girlfriend ko, if you love me, let's make love. Kahit hindi pa tayo kasal. Ikaw ang rason na nagkasala yung ano mo. Dinala mo ba siya sa kasalanan? Manood tayo ng, bunta tayo sa beer house. Manood tayo ng pornography. Yun. Have I harbored hatred in my heart, wishing them dead or worse to go to hell? Have I condoned sterilization, magpalaygit, or magpakapon? Lalo na sa mga OB ngayon, in-encourage nila mga tao magpalaygit at saka magpakapon. Have I engaged in sin against humanity, artificial insemination, in vitro fertilization, yung mga test tube babies, yung mga surrogate mothers, yun, kasalanan. Have I approved euthanasia? Have I taken someone's life directly or indirectly? Ikaw yung nagsuhol, magpapatay? Ikaw ay nagsabi na, yes, sige, okay lang, patayin yan. Yun, indirectly. Now, let's go to the sixth commandment, do not commit adultery. So, ang commandment number six, do not commit adultery, hindi lang yan adultery or nangabit ka na may asawa ka. It is about chastity and about to safeguard the procreative power. Chastity. So, yung sex, God created sex. God gave us the sexual act as a gift. It is sacred. Sagrado po siya. No? Hindi po siya pwedeng gamitin kasangkapan. Pwede lang siyang gamitin in the context of marriage. Pag ginamit mo siya outside of marriage, like premarital sex, it becomes evil. No? So, sexual relations, lahat ng sexual relation outside of marriage is a sin. It is condemned. Premarital sex or fornication. Homosexual act, di naman kasal yan. Lalaki sa lalaki, babae sa babae, hindi pwedeng makasal sa mata ng Diyos. Masturbation, sex with yourself. Pornography, no? Adultery. So, yung adultery, mga kapatid, dalawang klase. Physical adultery, so nakipag-adultery ka sa hindi mo kasal, no? Yung emotional adultery, yung sa emotion lang, sa isip, meaning emotionally involved ka with a married person. Hindi kayo nagtatalik, hindi kayo nagkikita, pero sa text or sa message or yung nag-uusap kayo, you express your feelings to one another already. Na-in love ka na sa kanya, meron na kayong parang mutual or kahit hindi mutual, kahit ikaw, yung ang emotion mo andun na sa kanya, sa married person or ikaw married sa isang single person. Emotional adultery, meron yan. You beware of that. Lahat ba ng sexual sin are pareho ang kanilang antas? Pareho ba ang kanilang gravity? No. May mga sexual sin na mas masahol sa isa. Example, ito. Lust, ano ang lust? Is an impure thoughts, that is lust. So, masturbation is worse than lust. Mas masahol pa siya sa lust dahil you are acting out your lust. Okay? So, huwag kayo maniwala sa mga theologians na magsasabi na hindi kasalanan pag hindi mo ginawa ang isang bagay. Pag andun pa lang sa yung isipan, hindi pa kasalanan. No. Kasalanan na yan. Hindi siya kasalanan pag pumasok siya sa isip mo, hindi mo pinatagal, hindi pa kasalanan yan. Pero pag pinatagal mo, impure thoughts, nag-i-enjoy ka na, kasalanan yan. No? Kasi nagkakasala tayo sa gawa, sa salita, sa isipan. Okay? Sa isipan, kakasala ka na. At sa hindi paggawa ng kailangang gawin. Okay, Matthew 5, sabi, you have heard that it was said, you shall not commit adultery, but I tell you that anyone who looks at a woman lustfully has already committed adultery with her in his heart. Yun. So, nakatingin ka pa lang sa isang woman lustfully, you have already committed adultery in your heart. Pornography is worse than fornication. Pornography is worse than fornication because it brings a third party. No? Homosexual sex is worse than premarital sex, premarital heterosexual sex. Ang premarital sex ay kasalanan, pero mas worse na kasalanan ng homosexual dahil sabi ni St. Thomas Aquinas, it is not natural, unnatural. No? But how do we treat homosexual people? We do not condemn. We understand, we should love them, we have to care for them, and we have to pray for them. And we should guide them. We do not condemn. Okay? So, as a summary of the Sixth Commandment, ang questions, have I engaged in any sexual activity with another person outside marriage? So, yun, basahin nyo na lang, hindi natin isa-isahin, no? Ito, importante. Am I careful to dress modestly? Yung pananamit natin, dapat hindi yung mga sexy. No? So, sa ating words, ating mga joke, green jokes, dapat modest tayo sa ating mga words, sa ating thoughts, sa ating action. Hindi dapat sexually expressive, sexually provocative. No? At saka, sa ating dress, are we dressing modestly or are we sexually turning on other people? No? Kahit pwede ka pang magmamaang-maangan dyan, ah, gusto ko lang maging ano, hindi naman ako nagsiseduce, but are you sexually turning on other people? Meron kang responsibility. Next, Seventh Commandment, you shall not steal. So, ang Seventh Commandment is about the commandment about justice. Hindi lang siya yung pagnanakaw, it is about justice. So, ang pagnanakaw, kinukod din na yan. No? It is a violation of justice. Robbery, using force. Ang pangungutang, hindi mo sinoli ang utang mo, tapos inuuna mo yung luho mo, tapos hindi mo binayaran yung utang mo, it is a sin. No? Kung mangungutang ka dahil sa emergency health reason, okay lang. Pero nangungutang ka dahil sa luho, at kahit nangungutang ka for emergency, kung meron, kaya mo nang magbayad, pero sinasadya mong hindi magbayad dahil inuna mo pa yung mga luho mo, kasalanan na yan. Okay? Nagda-damage ka ng mga property ng iba. That is against commandment number 7. Breach of contract. Hindi mo tinupad yung contract mo. That is sin. Nang hiram ka ng mga bagay, tinago mo, hindi mo sinoli. No? Libro o kahit ano paman. Cheating sa mga timbang. Nag-cheat ka sa false advertisement. Hindi mo binayaran ng tama yung mga workers mo. Tinitake advantage mo sila. No? At saka ikaw na worker, nagnanakaw ka ng oras sa amo mo. Nagtatamad-tamad ka. Nagle-late-late ka, tapos nilalagay mo yung hindi ka late pero late ka, no? Yung mga politicians, corruption, kickback, SOP, no? Lahat ng corruption. Bribery, no? Vote buying, no? Kahit makakalusot ka sa batas, sa mata ng Diyos, hindi ka makakalusot. Nagpagbibili ng mga nakaw na mga bagay, kahit duda ka lang, binili mo, mali yan. So, have I cheated anyone? What is justly done? So, ito yung mga summary ng mga questions, guide questions. Okay? At saka, ito ang, ano, number one, ito importante. Have I returned or made restitution of what I have stolen? So, sa mga nakaw, mga kapatid, sa mga kinurap mo, ang hindi natin alam, kahit mag-confess ka pa sa pare, hindi ka mapapatawad ng Diyos kung wala kang, hindi ka nagsisikap, hindi ka magsikap na isoli ang ninakaw mo. So, pag nagnakaw ka, hindi mo kailangang sabihin na ako ang nagnakaw kasi baka makulong ka, mawawagan ka ng trabaho. Hindi mo kailangang sabihin yon. Pwede mong isoli anonymously. Anonymously, isoli mo. Pero kailangan mo talagang isoli. Pag nangurap ka, nangurakot ka sa kabanang bayan, isoli mo. Kahit mag-confess ka pa, hindi ka mapapatawad ng Diyos pag hindi mo sinoli ang ninakaw mo. Yon. Maraming hindi alam yan. Akala nila, mag-confess ka lang, okay na. No. Part ng commandment number 7, ang restitution. At saka, yung 8th commandment, it's about truth. You shall not bear false witness against neighbor. Akala nila, chismis lang. Hindi yan chismis lang. It is about truth. So, ang calumny, worse. Nag-iimbento ka ng salit ng kwento na hindi totoo. Nasira ang reputation ng kapwa mo. That is very, very grave sin. Mortal sin. Maraming namatay, maraming nakulong. Yung planting of evidence, planting rice, planting of evidence, tapos ikaw, nag-ano ka pa, oh, totoo yan. Pero nakulong siya dahil sa planting of evidence, grabe. Grabe yan. Impyerno ka talaga yan. Sin of rash judgment, nag-judge ka na sa isip mo. Wala pa siyang ginagawang masama. Sabi mo, oh, naglilinis-linis, nagpapasip-sip lang yan sa isip mo. Rash judgment yan. And then, detraction, nakita mo isang tao, isang pare, lumabas sa hotel, pinagkalat mo sa kahit sino. Wala naman siyang, wala naman siyang right na malaman, hindi niya kilala si father, sinabi mo, nasira ang reputation ni father, o kahit hindi lang si father, ano mga bagay. Ayan, lasenggo. Tatawag ka pa sa Manila, alam mo, eto. Hindi naman niya kailangan malaman. Pero pag kailangan ng isang tao malaman, hindi kasalanan. Pero yung isang tao, wala naman siyang karapatang malaman, pinagsasabi mo, tawag dyan, detraction. Ito yung chismis na totoo. Kasalanan pa rin. Okay? Sabihin nila, no, it's not gossip, it's the truth. No, kasalanan pa rin. It's called the sin of detraction. Yung chismis na hindi totoo, tawag dyan, calumny. Ang tawag ng chismis na totoo, tawag dyan, detraction. Okay? Tsaka meron sins of the ear. nakikinig ka ng chismis, naaaliw ka dahil ang chismis ay galit ka sa taong yon. Sin of the ear yan. Kasalanan. You have to change the topic. Okay? And then, tale-bearing. Nagsasabi mo anong sinasabi na dapat secret lang. No? So, kailangan mo rin ng restitution. I-repair mo rin ang damage pag naggawa ka na. Salita ka ng mga hindi totoo na damage yung reputation niya, sabihin mo rin ang bawiin mo rin dapat. Hindi ka mapapatawad pag hindi mo binawi. Okay? Ito yung mga guide question sa commandment number 8. So, have I lied? White lies? Even white lies, kasalanan. No? So, yung bragging, ito number 5, bragging. Hindi totoo, nagyayabang ka. At saka yung ano rin, for example, may amo ka, tapos yung ginawa ng amo mo hindi naman maganda, tapos sabihin mo, ay, ang galing-galing mo, kahit hindi naman maganda yung ginawa niya, no? Amo mo, isang politician. Tapos sabihin mo, ay, ang galing-galing mo, hindi naman, pinupuri mo siya kahit hindi totoo, pinupuri mo siya kasi gusto mo lang ma-promote, gusto mo lang magpasip-sip, that is sin, no? That is flattery. 9th commandment, do not covet your neighbor's wife, it's a sin of thought. Ito yung mga guide question, kayo na lang basahin kasi lagpas na tayo sa oras. Have I caused impure thoughts by reading movies, TV, conversation, or curiosity? Or if I know a movie, alam mong isang movie, maraming sexual scenes, bed scenes, pinapanood mo pa rin, kasalanan yon, no? Commandment number 9 yan. No? Nung may pumasok sa isip mo na mga malalaswa, may ginawa ka ba para matanggal ito? You have to pray 3 Hail Marys kaagad. No? Nag-flirt ba ako sa mga na hindi ko asawa? Yung nagpapalandi-landi ka, pinupuri mo siya, tinitoy mong emotion niya, hindi mo naman siya asawa, dalaga siya. Gusto mo lang ma-challenge ba, parang ego mo ba na may ma-inlove pa sa'yo, na pwede ka pa? No, that is commandment number 9. Sin against commandment number 9. No? Sexually suggestive flirting. Ang commandment number 9 ay partner ng commandment number 6, thou shall not commit adultery. Yung commandment number 9, kasalanan sa isip. Yung mayroon kang desire na kunin mong asawa ng iba. No? Or mang-aagaw ka. Or hindi ka pa, kahit hindi ka pa married, pwede kang magka-commit ng commandment number 9. Sin against lust, no? Sa isip. Okay, now let's go to commandment number 10. You shall not covet your neighbor's goods. Yung nagde-desire ka na kunin yung mga property ng iyong kapwa. So, the desire to take, keep, or damage what somebody else has. So, hindi mo pa dinakaw, gusto mong nakawin. Gusto mong agawin. Oh, yun. Parang sin of envy. Parang inggit, naiinggit ka. So, kaya tayo pinagbabawalan ng Diyos na mag-isip ng masama na kukunin. Kahit sa isip pa lang na kukunin mo, pinagbabawalan na tayo ng Diyos. Commandment number 10. Bakit? Eto. James chapter 1 verse 15. Anong sabi? After the desire, yung mayroon kang desire na kunin, after the desire has conceived, pag nabuo yan, yung pagnanais mo, paghahangad mo na kunin, ito ay manganganak. It will give birth to sin. Manganganak ng kasalanan. And sin, when it is full grown, it gives birth to death. Mortal sin. Kasi lahat ng kasalanan, saan nagsisimula? Sa isipan. Kaya sa isipan pa lang, ayaw ni Lord na isipin mo. Kaya mag-ingat tayo. Commandment number 10. Isipin mong kunin, agawin, o i-damage yung pagmamayari ng kapwa natin. Kasalanan sa isip. Yung commandment number 7, thou shall not steal, partner niya ang commandment number 10. kasalanan sa isip. Yung commandment number 6 at sa commandment number 9, partner. Thou shall not commit adultery. Yung 9, kasalanan sa isip. You want to commit adultery. No? So, ito yung kanyang guide question. Kayo na lang magbasa, i-post nyo na lang. No? Jealous ba ako kung anong sa iba? Nalulungkot ba ako pag nakarinig ako na nag-asenso yung kapwa ko? No? Meron ba akong attachment to things, cell phones, laptops, car houses? Am I upset when I see the success of someone else? No? So, yun ang mga questions. So, may we have a fruitful Lent. Magninilay, mag-reflect. We have to repent of our sins. Ito yung panahon na si Lord, tinubos niya tayo. We have to do our part. No? We have to confess. You have to make a good confession using the guide ng Ten Commandments at yung Seven Deadly Sins. Yun yung lecture natin last week, Seven Deadly Sins. No? So, I hope naka-learn tayo. Pasensya na, medyo mabilis tayo. Okay, Sis May, good evening. Open your microphone. Can you lead the closing prayer?
Okay, Doc, may gabi. In the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us
daily bread. Give us our daily bread. Forgive us our sins. Forgive us our sins.
Thank you, Sis May, for the closing prayer. Brother Dan, thank you again. Sis Josie.
Thank you, Doc. Salamat.
Everyone, see you next week. Thank you. God bless.
Good, Doc.
Hello.